there's at least one country where now anybody who uses a social networking site or web service under a certain size has to register with their national ID number. And a number of human rights groups have expressed concerns about some users who have been traced for political speech. As a result, at least one international social networking service decided to disable the local uploading of videos and comments onto their service, so that people in that country have to use the international version of the service, not the local service, in order to, so that the this particular social networking site would not be in the position of handing people over for speech that might arguably be political. So this kind of broad range of how crime is defined ends up putting companies in a difficult position. And finally, we also see a situation which was alluded to by Sunil, where administrators of social networking sites, global social networking sites, will perceive something as being against the terms of service when it's intended to be quite different from what they think. So politically, sometimes it ends up having implications. There are political activists from a range of countries who found their Facebook accounts frozen because their pattern of activity resembled spamming, and this had an impact on their ability to conduct political activities. And there have also been situations where on video hosting sites and photo hosting sites where political activists in various countries were posting images of abuse by authorities against citizens, and these were quite graphic and deemed to be against terms of service. And the people concerned felt that, you know, if even these sites do not enable me to speak truth to power, where can I go? So that's another sort of human rights issue.